to 10 on KTEK.
Are you behind on your taxes? The IRS is the largest and most aggressive collection agency in the world, and they can seize your bank account, garnish your paycheck, close your business, and file criminal charges. Tax Mediation Services is accredited by the Better Business Bureau. Our team of tax attorneys and enrolled agents can stop collections and get you protected. If you owe over $10,000 in back taxes or have unfiled tax returns, call now for a free case review and a price protection guaranteed quote at 800-207-1265. 800-207-1265.
The following program, paid for by Right Path Real Estate, does not necessarily represent the views or opinions
Tom.
Of the staff, management,
okay,
or
just making sure.
It's time to get on the
I hear you moving around. I didn't hear anything.
With Tom Perry. Get the answer to your question that's keeping you from taking action and succeeding today.
Do you see my calendar by any chance?
Nope.
You're coming in today?
Yeah, I have to help with the 12 o'clock.
Okay.
Get ready. The guide that will put your fears behind you is on the air now. Taking calls at 713-785-1817. Toll free 877-881-0271. Now here's your host, Tom Perry.
Hot mics.
Hey, welcome to the show. Right Path Real Estate Radio. Our call in number is 713-785-1817. We are helping people create a life of abundance by shifting mindsets, implementing proven systems, and facilitating a community of action takers. That's what Right Path Real Estate is really all about. This is Build Your Team Thursday, one of my favorite days of the week. I want to go live to the call-in hotline. You know, you're in business for yourself, but not by yourself. Your net worth is directly related to the size and strength of your network. One of the persons that I can consider a very good friend, and I am pleased that he's in my network, Mr. Ashley Patton, Patton Law Firm. Welcome to the show. How are you doing, brother?
Hey, Tom, I'm doing very good. I mean, how do I follow up with an introduction like that? I mean, that is a killer introduction.
Well, I tell you what, it's all from the heart. And I think you've known me for a while. You saw me when I got started, when I didn't know anything about real estate. You saw me through the transitions from construction to investor to educator to mentor. You've seen the progression from start to finish. And what I can tell you is that, you know, every now and then I face situations, I go, holy smokes, I have never seen that before. And what I love about my network is that I know the people that are tens at what they do. And we have a saying around Right Path to let the tens do it. And you're definitely a 10 at what you do. So whenever I get into a title issue, whenever I get into a legal contract related to real estate issue, I go, you know what, Ashley, I've never seen this before. Have you seen? And I think sometimes you go, oh, my God, I've never seen this before either. But at least you know the law. You've been to law school.
You know, it's amazing how law continues to change and evolve, and what was good today may not be good tomorrow, and that's why it's important for everybody to stay, you know, as you said, have a good network, because not everybody can learn everything, but everybody knows somebody who knows everything.
Yeah, it's impossible to know it all. It's absolutely impossible to know it all. There's too much information to know. You can't be an expert on financing. You know, the people that I know that we refer to that are on the lending side of things, they're absolute tens. And that is, if you're full-time in that, you see it change and morph, and new products are coming out because, you know, let's face it, lending, they have to market their services because lending is competitive. And the same thing with title, and the same thing with construction, and the same, and all of those. You know, there had never really been an established process for how do you put back the vapor barrier between the bricks and the 2x4s that we had to discover how to do that as a result of Harvey. I mean, nobody had ever really seen that before in the mass scale. But, you know, you work with people that are tens at what they do, and you figure out the right way, the right process. And that's what I love about the network we have right here at Right Path. And I can't say how happy I am that you're a part of the network and the value that you bring to me, you know, as a friend and also as a person I consider a business associate, and then also to our members. So I just want to say thanks.
Well, I appreciate it, Tom, and you're more than welcome. I mean, it's just a I'm here for you, and I'm here for everybody to where it's just a at the end of the day, if we're not growing, we're dying.
Absolutely.
I mean, we're always having to evolve. I mean, it's just a I got a phone call 2 days ago, and they were, you know, this lady had been renting her house out on Airbnb, and she got one of the nasty letters from the HOA, you know, company saying, "Hey,
you can't do
you're
that.
Not supposed to be doing this.
Cease and desist, right?"
That's right.
Right.
And so I just sent her a copy of a recent Supreme Court case and says, "Hey, send them this.
Yeah.
They'll learn."
Yeah. Yeah, a lot of people,
so it's just
a lot of people don't know,
you know,
that HOA,
I mean,
HOAs may have bylaws that are actually trumped by federal law, right? So they may say, well, here, look, we're going to send you a cease and desist because you've got to abide by our HOA rules according to our doctrine, but there's a super, you know, seating overarching rule about that, right?
That's correct. You know, Airbnb is considered a trade. You know, it's not considered commercial business. So, you know, not unlike, you know, somebody, a guest coming to visit your house, that's the way the Airbnb is considered. So it's actually it's a good ruling. And I think the Supreme Court rendered it. I want to say it was in March or April or May. It might have been May of this year. But, you know, it's great ruling for all those people who actually buy rentals and they Airbnb them, because obviously you can get a lot more money in the right area for an Airbnb than you can, you know, putting out on the regular monthly rental pool, because it's just when you get paid per day, it's always better than getting paid per month.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, in fact, it's also a great strategy for some of these higher-end houses where the neighborhoods haven't really bounced back yet. And I know that... You know, I believe that there's a lot of houses that are out there that if you rehabbed them now and you were finished by, like, let's say December, that you could put them on the market in December, but, you know, the peak buying season, I'm not going to say you can't sell a house in, you know, January, February, March, et cetera, because, you know, what I've actually looked at the numbers and found that, you know, May, June, July, August, you know, that those 4 months, those are, you know, more active than the other 8 months of the year, but it's not like it's 50% of the volume is done in those 4 months and the other 50 is done in the other. It's much closer. It's about a 7% peak in those 3 months versus an average month, which really is not that big of a deal in the grand scheme of things. But I know that we have a property, for example, that we've been trying to sell it in the 430 range, and pre-flood, probably pushing above 500. And I think that, you know, if I can hold on to it till May, June, July, somewhere in there, it's going to be a $500,000 house again. So if I can get a little bit of revenue to cover my holding costs, so I'm Airbnb-ing that house. In fact, we're buying the furniture next week, and it'll go on Airbnb, and I'll be able to have some testimonials and teach people how to do that. So if you ever get in that situation, as long as you have longer-term financing in place, and, you know, there's some products out there, some 24-month hard money loans, things like that, that you can hold on to properties longer. And, you know, think if I sold it now at 430 versus I sell it in May for 500, I mean, that's, yeah, it's going to cost me a little bit of money in holding, but I'll make $70,000 in the sales price. I can hang on to it.
Now, was that house flooded?
Yes, absolutely. It's over in Fleetwood.
Oh, okay, got it.
You know, it's which is a great area. In fact, it's not too far from our brand new office, and you know, it's been a well established area. But basically, all of Fleetwood got hammered. And versus like a Wilchester or something like that, where people seem like in Wilchester, a little bit further east along Memorial, those folks got into remodeling their houses pretty quickly. It seemed like that the people out in Fleetwood, they were really waiting on, it's almost like they didn't have the extra cash to get it started. They could afford the nice house, but they couldn't, you know, afford all the extras, you know what I mean? And so
right.
It seemed like they were waiting on the insurance money to get started, which all the delays with that and things like that. So there's still a lot of houses. There's still much construction still going on there, whereas Wilchester's probably, there's some construction going on, but it's probably an 80-20, 80% complete, 20% construction versus it's probably opposite of that in Fleetwood. But I feel like that when those houses come back, and we've got one of the nicer houses in the neighborhood, that it's going to be a $500,000 house. So if you can just afford to hang on, then, you know, Airbnb is a great strategy to hang on.
Yeah, it really is, because it's a, you know, especially with the HOA out of the equation. I mean, it's really opens the door for a lot of people to Airbnb it.
Yeah, so what do you think long-term, I mean, economically, if lots and lots of people start getting into Airbnb, I mean, what is that going to do to the economics of Airbnb?
You know, obviously, it's only a matter of time before all cities fall by the wayside of San Francisco. Now, San Francisco was getting hammered by Airbnb, so much so where they went and controlled Airbnb to where, I mean, because if you think about it, I mean, I think 32% of your hotel has, you know, there's a 32% hotel occupancy tax.
Yes.
And so the city lives and thrives on the hotel tax. Yes. I mean, that's one of their things. But unless Airbnb, it's not being charged.
2 minutes.
And wait, that's going to be the first thing that we see.
Yeah, I agree. Well, in fact, you know, I remember that occupancy tax when they passed it in Houston and all of that, that one of the things that they do is like, oh, we're going to raise taxes on all the out-of-towners that are coming into town. That way the local people, that's how the politicians sell it, is that we're going to tax all these people that are coming in from out of town that are on business expenses and things like that. And that way the local people aren't actually going to, you know, feel that tax. But the reality is there's a lot of local people that pay for hotels, you know, for whatever reason that is.
Well, you're exactly right. Let's face it, you know, that money, I mean, it's just once it's in the system, you know, it's you know, it goes away from the system just as quickly as it gets in. And so, you know, and it goes to the general coffers. And, you know, I mean, it's election month. So, you know, don't even get me started, I guess.
Yeah, right. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, in fact, I'll be voting today. I've got to go downtown and vote. It's a long story, but and I don't have time for it on the air. But Ashley, I know we're running out of time, and it's great to have you on the air again. And I can't wait to see you at the next event. And and if you need any...
Sounds great, Tom. Thanks so much for having me.
Yeah, absolutely. I just want to give out your contact information. It's plfpc.com. That's plfpc.com, 713-621-5808, 713-621-5808. Give Ashley Patton and Patton Law Firm a call. Texas American Title, one of the best title companies in the marketplace. Give them a call.
Hey, thanks so much, Tom.
Thanks, right, Ashley. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
Mic's off.
All right, man. So it's Juan calling in for Quest?
Yes.
Are you looking for an investor-friendly general contractor for your investment property? Then
oh,
call
no,
Fast Track Remodeling at
832-742-9992
or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Fast Track Remodeling specializes in turnkey remodeling of single-family investment properties. Whether it's a flip rehab or a rental rehab, we manage every aspect of a rehab from start to finish with a highly efficient, standardized process.
Over the last 6 years, Fast Track has completed over 700 projects, which has helped us to create our three keys to success. Use a detailed scope of work so that everything gets done, train and maintain quality crews so it gets done right, and complete the work in a proper order so it gets done fast.
No more managing it yourself. No more doing the work yourself. Fast Track Remodeling really does manage it all.
So give us a call today at 832-742-9992. Again, that's 832-742-9992. Or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
3 minutes left.
Yes.
Time is money in a real estate deal. If your insurance company is slow or non-responsive, you could lose a deal like that. You need a quick turnaround on quotes or binders? The agency for that is Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas. The team at Benchmark understands the investor mindset. They know what you need and when you need it. We're here for you. Are you a rehabber, wholesaler, buy and hold, or flipper? Bundling your properties on a single policy will help save time and money. Benchmark has been in business for over 10 years, and we insure over 30,000 properties. Contact Benchmark about our exclusive investor package. Call us and let us show you what we can do for you at 281-569-4353. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com. That's benchmarkbroker.com. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com.
Hi, Clint Coons here, attorney and avid real estate investor. You know the greatest mistake real estate investors make is not understanding the potential liability that exists from owning real estate. At Anderson Business, Legal, and Tax Advisors, we specialize in protecting real estate investors in all 50 states. In addition to structuring your business for optimum protection, we provide guidance so you pay the least amount of taxes available under the law. We have 150 employees that range from lawyers to CPAs to estate planners and much more. Download our free ebook, The Invisible Investor Strategy, today at AndersonAdvisors.com or call for a free risk reduction analysis and financial blueprint at 800-706-4741. Anderson Business Advisors will help you keep more of what you earn. Call us today at 800-706-4741 and mention Right Path Real Estate.
Did you know that there are over $24 trillion in retirement accounts in the U.S.? Imagine if you could use someone's IRA to fund all of your deals. Well, you can. Quest IRA is based locally here in Houston, Texas. At Quest IRA, we offer retirement accounts that can be used to invest in real estate, promissory notes, private entities, and much more. Many of our clients loan money from their IRAs to fund real estate deals all over the country. We don't sell any investments or give advice. However, we do hold free networking events, weekly educational classes, and free consultations with an IRA specialist.
I'm playing a recorded for this one.
For more information, visit our website.
I'm playing a recorded for this one.
Or call us at 1-855-FUN-IRAs. To tap into the $24 trillion in retirement accounts in the U.S., call Quest IRA at 1-855-FUN-IRAs or go to our website, questira.com.
This is Business 1110.
Welcome back. Right Path Real Estate Radio. Want to get right to our call-in hotline. I've got Derek with Quest IRA. Derek, welcome to the show. How are you?
I'm doing great, Tom. How are you?
I'm doing really well. So I saw Pineapple Man last night.
So you saw that, did you? That was awesome.
Absolutely. Yeah, in fact, you know, I was scheduled to go on stage next, and then Pineapple Man said, "Hey, this costume's really, really warm. Any chance I can go in front of you?" I'm like, "Yeah, man. I'm a team player. Go for it." So, yes, I absolutely saw it, and I thought it was fantastic.
So, as you said, you know, Nate last night, he was at the Jet Lending event, the big Redneck Country Club thing they host every month, and he dressed up as a giant pineapple to help promote our Fright Night event.
Yes, he
now, did. last year, Tom, we had 450 people show up. As of this morning, we have 490 people registered. So,
wow.
We're almost at capacity, assuming, you know, obviously some of the people that registered won't show up, but it's already going to be a packed house, packed event. Everything is on Quest. We're paying for all the alcohol and all of the food, and it's going to be a really, really fun event coming up here on Fright Night next Thursday.
Yeah, I'm excited about it. I'm absolutely thrilled about it. In fact, I've always had a schedule conflict with every other one of the Quest Fright Nights that y'all have done. I've never been to one. And I couldn't be more thrilled. Yeah, I know. Hard to believe. Yes, but I've had every single year since I got started in real estate, I've had a scheduling conflict until this one. And this one, I got it on the calendar so far in advance that I do not have a scheduling conflict, and I am thrilled to be able to be there. Now, my dilemma is, you know, I'm not great at costumes. That's not my specialty. And, you know, I'm a tenant some things. You know, like I'm a tenant flipping houses. I'm a tenant wholesaling houses. I'm a tenant wholesaling. I'm a tenant at buy and hold. I'm a tenant sales. I'm not a tenant picking costumes. Like, I would have never considered going as a pineapple. That's just me. But he pulled it off great last night. Now, I have to say, I'm thrilled. I spent about 6 weeks trying to figure out what would be an appropriate costume. I will not reveal on the air today what I'm going as, but I have to say I'm absolutely thrilled with what I've selected, and it took a while to order all the pieces, and they've all come in thanks to Amazon. Give Amazon a free plug, not like they need it. They're kind of ubiquitous anyway, right? But yeah,
right.
I'm thrilled to be there. I will be at Fright Night, October the 25th. Tell all the details. What's the location, all of that?
Yeah, so Fright Night is next Thursday, October 25th, and it's at a place called Duquesa. It's off of Chimney Rock, 2840 Chimney Rock Road here in Houston. The view is absolutely gorgeous. I got to see it for the first time, not just the pictures, but physically go there the other day, and it is so awesome. It really is. If you have a chance, all you have to do is Google Duquesa, and you'll see it. It comes right up at the top of Google, and the venue is amazing. Once again, this event, it's really a way to meet real estate investors in a different light, which is how come everything is on us, right? You get to have the free food, the free alcohol, and not like, oh, here's two tickets. No, everything is on us, and I don't know, it's just a lot of fun. You really get to network with a lot of the higher-end investors, such as yourself, Tom, like you said. It's nice to hang out with someone such as you, and a lot of people, they see you on stage, and they get nervous to approach you, and they get nervous to speak with you and talk with you, and it's nice to kind of meet you in a different atmosphere. And that's really what this event is about, is just bringing people together. Let them talk, let them network, pump them full of alcohol, pump them full of free food. And on top of that, we are bringing in the speakers to talk about a different side of real estate. So everyone who's going to be one of our speakers presenting is only talking about their bad investment stories. And understand, those bad investment stories are the realistic side of the investment area that a lot of people they forget about. They only see the good stuff. So I think it's nice to bring in people that are experts, that they have made their mistakes and they've learned from their mistakes, and it helps us not make, you know, and when I say us, I'm talking about myself being a newer investor. It helps, you know, some of the newer people not make those same mistakes. So it's one of the best things about Fright Night. So, and it's next Thursday, October 25th. Register, guys, we have to stop the registration at 600 people. So we're getting pretty close to that. We only have about 100 slots left open. It is completely free. You just have to go online, type in your name, your first name, last name, and email, and boom, you're registered. So,
yeah, you want to make sure that you do that. You don't want to be left out of one of the biggest parties, not just one of the biggest, because biggest is not always better, but it's one of the best parties of the entire year. You know, all the stories that I've ever heard of previous ones, I can only imagine, since this will be the biggest one that y'all have ever done, this will absolutely be the best. I know it'll get wild, it'll get crazy. The stories will be amazing. I know I'm going to be sharing three of our scariest stories. And, you know, when you've done over 500 different, you know, flips, plus wholesales, plus buy and hold, plus some of the crazy title things that we get involved in, I've got three fabulous, you know, great, scary stories. And you're right, you learn. You know, it's not the bread and butter stories that where everything works out perfectly that you learn about. There's lots and lots of stories. And if you understand how much fraud's going on in real estate right now and things like that, what you can do to protect. In fact, we closed on a house yesterday that we were selling at retail, and the people that they got an email, and it was a hoax email essentially that said, if you wire immediately, you know, then we'll give you a $70, you know, rebate off of your, you know, your wiring fees. And your transaction fees. And so, yeah, the people wired their down payment over $300,000. Thank goodness the bank put a hold on it. So the scammers didn't get the money, but it was really, really close. And thank goodness the agents and so there's a lot of scary stuff going on out there. And I'm sure you hear those kind of stories as well. You see it on your side as well. So what other events do you have coming up this next week besides the Fright Night? I mean, I know Fright Night's going to be the biggest one, but tell us about your Tuesday morning events.
Yeah, so actually, every Tuesday, as you know, Tom, Quest hosts free classes right out of our classroom here near the Katy office in Houston. And this next Tuesday is going to be one of our busiest classes. Now, you don't have to register anything. Please feel free to show up. But Quincy Long, our president, is going to be the one teaching the class, and he's going to be teaching how to take a small account, turn it into a large account completely tax-free. He calls it his Roth conversion class. We always tell people, like, hey, our classes last 45 minutes. There's no kicking Quincy off the stage, though.
Yeah, right.
So he finishes when he finishes. But it really, really is unique. If you never have had a chance to hear Clinty speak, his knowledge, not just in real estate, but on tax code and everything else, is unbelievable. This guy is really one of the smartest men I've ever met in my entire life. So he's teaching this next Tuesday, but we do host classes every single Tuesday, completely free, open to the public at 9:30 in the morning.
Yeah, so you don't want to miss that. So two events next week you want to definitely catch is their Tuesday morning event plus the Thursday night Fright Night at Duquesa. You want to go to QuestIRA.com. That's Quest, Q-U-E-S-T-I-R-A.com, or call 855-FUN-IRAs. That's 855-FUN-IRAs. So, Derek, what are you going as next week?
Ooh, so, like you, Tom, I'm terrible about picking out costumes. So my girlfriend went and she picked out one of those couples costumes that we're going to do. I'm not allowed to reveal it yet. It is going to be a little bit of a surprise. But unfortunately, I had to shave my beard. If you've seen me before, you know I have a little beard. And she's made me shave it so she could do my makeup. So,
So your costume includes makeup. All right. Is there any gender change going on or anything like that we should know about?
No. Not with myself, anyways.
Okay, good. All right. Want to make sure. Hey, guys, you can tell how much fun it's going to be. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
I definitely don't want to miss it. That's coming up. Oh, go ahead.
Yeah, I said you definitely don't want to miss it.
No, definitely not. We do have another event coming up on November 8th. It's called an NCE. It's completely free. It does last about 3 to 3.5 hours, right? And that event is for real estate agents. Every year, agents and brokers have to get a specific amount of education hours. So we host an event for you to get your education hours completely free, and we buy you lunch. So that's November 8th, starting at 10 a.m. If anyone wants to attend that, please let me know as well. We do ask you to register so we order everyone enough lunch. That's also right here at the Quest IRA office.
So two on the Book of Faces is asking the question, what time is the Quest meeting? I assume she means the Tuesday morning meeting, so that's at 9 a.m., correct? At 1771 Park Road.
Yeah, 9:30.
9:30. Okay.
Yeah.
So you probably want to show up at 9. If it starts at 9:30, then you probably want to show up at 9, and that's at 17171 Park Row, and that's in Houston, Texas, out towards the Katy area. It's not actually in Katy, but it's actually in Houston. But just Google that. Go to 17171 Park Row. Go to QuestIRA.com. You can find out all the schedule, all the times. You can register for the events. It's completely free to register. And you want to make sure that now that the event for Fright Night, that's actually going to be Thursday, October the 25th. What time does that start?
That starts around 6:30, and it just goes till it ends, to be honest.
It just goes till it ends. And then I hear, is there an after party after the party?
Sometimes there is. Sometimes there isn't. Depends on
you just
the
have to show up to find out, right?
Exactly.
Right. So, if there is an after party, you certainly don't want to miss that.
That's correct. And then I will see you tonight as well, won't I, Tom?
Absolutely. We've got an event tonight. It's our fourth quarter update, and I'll see you at the Crown Plaza across from IKEA on I-10. I'll look forward to seeing you tonight. Thanks for being on, Derek.
Yeah, thank you, Tom. I appreciate it.
All right. Have a great day.
You too.
All right, everybody, thanks for listening. Stay tuned through the break. We'll be back on the other side.
Did you know that there are over $24 trillion in retirement accounts in the U.S.? Imagine if you could use someone's IRA to fund all of your deals. Well, you can. Quest IRA is based locally here in Houston, Texas. At Quest IRA, we offer retirement accounts that can be used to invest in real estate, promissory notes, private entities, and much more. Many of our clients loan money from their IRAs to fund real estate deals all over the country. We don't sell any investments or give advice. However, we do hold free networking events, weekly educational classes, and free consultations with an IRA specialist. For more information, visit our website at questira.com or call us at 1-855-FUN-IRAs. To tap into the $24 trillion in retirement accounts in the U.S., call Quest IRA at 1-855-FUN-IRAs or go to our website, questira.com.
Do you have cracks in your brick, doors that stick, or sheetrock that's coming apart? Then you may have...
All right, Johnny's on hold.
Due to our expansive soils in the Houston area, it's probably not a question of if you have movement, but when. Call Foundation Check for a truly independent, unbiased foundation evaluation. Foundation Check has been in business since 2009 and has completed over 1,400 evaluations. We're not in the business of repairing foundations or selling you unnecessary
Curing, stand by, let me look.
But we are in the business of evaluating your foundation.
2.5.
Our product is designed for house flippers, landlords, or even owner-occupied properties. Each of our files is reviewed by a licensed engineer. Remember to check before every repair. Call 346-702-3825. That's 346-702-3825. Or you can reach us online at foundationcheck.com. That's foundationcheck.com.
Are you looking for an investor-friendly general contractor for your investment property? Then call Fast Track Remodeling at 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Fast Track Remodeling specializes in turnkey remodeling of single-family investment properties, whether it's a flip, rehab, or a rental rehab. No more managing it yourself. No more doing the work yourself. Fast Track Remodeling really does manage it all.
So give us a call today at 832-742-9992.
Hello, real estate investors. Do you need a lender that moves fast at the speed of a jet to fund your investment properties? Jet Lending will help you purchase properties quickly with as little cash out of pocket as possible. Jet Lending also sets up a repair escrow fund to help you with repair costs. Jet Lending is your fast and friendly hard money source for first-time investors and seasoned professionals. Call 281-872-7800 or email us at info@jetlending.com.
You found or inherited a great investment property. Problem is, you don't know how much it's worth, or more importantly, what to do to maximize your investment while mitigating risk. This is exactly why we started Next Gen Appraisals. Next Gen is a group of appraisers specializing in investment real estate. We understand that investors aren't just looking for a number of what their property is worth, but a comprehensive analysis of the market. Give Next Gen a call at 713-346-9911 or check us out online at nextgenappraisals.com.
Taxes.
All right, 30
just
seconds.
The sound of that word makes people cringe. At Anderson Advisors, we provide tax reduction through asset protection for real estate investors throughout the country. Our unique philosophy has CPAs, lawyers, bookkeepers, and estate planners with one common goal, helping you, the real estate investor. Check us out today at AndersonAdvisors.com. And don't forget to tell us you heard about us at Right Path Real Estate.
This is Business 1110.
All right, here we go. Hot mics.
Hey, welcome back. Right Path Real Estate Radio, 713-785-1817 if you want to give us a call. Want to get right back to our call-in hotline, Mr. Johnny Hayes, Jet Lending. How are you doing, my friend?
Hey, Tom. How's it going?
Doing really well, man. It's a busy time of year, isn't it?
Good. It's a very busy time of year. So a lot of investors, a lot of deals out there still. You know, we hear all this national some loom and gloom and doom that things are turning. Well, it ain't turning in Texas that way. Seems to be just heading straight on up.
Yeah, that's what I would agree. In fact, you know what's interesting? I had this conversation day before yesterday with somebody that we just moved into new offices at 13501 K Freeway. And we're in some, you know, almost like executive suites. We've taken over like a whole chunk of offices while our offices are being built out. And the building official open day is today. And we actually moved in on Saturday. So it's been kind of an interesting thing getting the studio set up and all that. Well, there was this guy, and he's been a builder in the past, and he's invested, and he's a financial planner for folks right now. He's been a developer and all that. And he said, well, you know, people are saying the market's doing this, or it's about to crash, or it's doing, I'm like, you know, it depends on what part. I mean, real estate is really big. And what multifamily is going to do is different than what retail's doing, is different than what industrial's doing, is different than what storage units are doing, is different than even within single family, what houses below, let's say, 180,000 all the way down to maybe 75,000. What that's doing is different than what million-dollar houses are doing. I mean, it's just, it's such a segmented market that you can't paint with a broad brush. And then, And then mostly, you know, what I look at is like, you know, when Warren Buffett speaks, people listen, right? And so he may
That's
make
right.
a comment about, well, real estate's, you know, on the downturn or housing starts or this or that. And it's like he's looking at it from, you know, San Francisco to Maine. And, you know, from
That's
Florida
right.
to Seattle, and it's like there are so many submarkets that, you know, like Las Vegas had gone through a crash, but I hear that Las Vegas is starting to boom again, and so is Arizona.
Yeah.
It had gone through a crash, and it's starting to do well again. And for sure, I mean, Houston had gone through a recession. You know, remember when Dr. Dotsauer was speaking at, you know, at our event, and he basically was saying that Houston's coming out of a recession. I'm like, what recession? I mean, it's been booming for us. We did extremely well.
No, I know. Yeah.
Yeah. So you have to know what's going on with the local market. And how do you do that? You talk to local guys like Johnny. You're one of the experts. You see a lot of deals. How many deals do you look at for other investors on an average month, would you say?
Oh, gosh, we 1,000.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, it's, you know, every day, you know, we get deals that come across. I mean, I got guys pulling comps every day, helping investors figure out what properties are, you know, making sure they get into good deals. That's one thing Jet's done. You know, we've been lending here in Houston for 15 years. We've been flipping houses for 20. So we're investors that loan to other investors. And once we help analyze these deals for the guys, we're here to help our clients get into deals that make sense, that can make them money. Now, if they're trying to flip, you need to be buying at a certain point because deals are worth it and repairs are what repairs are. Now, if you want to buy and hold, every little market's a little different. I mean, I got investors that are paying close to retail to buy houses in certain good appreciative markets that are close to them because they have a lot of cash sitting in the banks making low percentages that they can raise their return on their cash, plus in 10 years with appreciation and principal pay down, build millions of extra equity in their properties and have net worth for their retirement.
Yeah, absolutely. That's the best way. You know, you can make some quick cash if you're flipping houses. And I think people get caught up with, oh my gosh, I can make a quick $50,000. And that's fantastic if you're behind the eight ball in terms of finances, but that really doesn't move the needle like buying a buy and hold property does in terms of building wealth and income. When you start looking about leveraged appreciation and how that grows people's real wealth, you could flip 12 houses a year, make $600,000, you know, over the next 10 years, make $6 million. But how much are you actually going to keep of that $6 million? You could buy 10 or 15 rental properties and just watch your net worth grow over the next 5 years. It's going to be $4, $5, $6, $8, $10 million, much more so than you would even flipping houses. And with a lot less effort. Now, we'll teach you how to flip because you and I, we're both fans of flipping. You guys flip, so do we. And
sure.
And y'all are a great lender for flipping. And one of the new products that I'm excited that y'all have is to tell us about this Jet 24.
Yeah, we've been working on this with one of our partners, and now we have a product that we can start out at a 9.9% interest rate, and it's a 24-month loan for investors that may want to try to sell because they're not in a position to buy and hold. But if they can't sell it quickly, it allows them to also hold that property maybe up to 24 months to where they may get in a position to be able to refi or just keep their options open, you know, to where they don't have any extra extension fees or anything. So it's a great product out there. I've got a lot of our home investor guys that we do a lot of business with. Hey, it gives them the option. They may want to wholesale, they may want to hotel it, they may want to retail it, or they may want to hold it and decide before they do anything else. And that product's out there. All of our investors have been asking for it. We got it ready. Give us a call at 281-872-7800 or email us at info@jetlending.com and ask about the Jet 24, and we'll give you all the things and get you pre-approved for a loan for it.
So something else that I'd like you to talk about is I know a lot of brand new investors, they see what a hard money lender charges, things like that, and let's say that they're buying a buy and hold. and they don't really understand why would you buy the property with hard money, fix it up, and then refinance out. What are the advantages? How does that work? Can you talk about, you know, if you're refinancing out into a Fannie Mae mortgage, something like that, what's the advantage of buying with hard money first?
Well, the key with doing a double close is us as an asset-based lender will close that first loan based off of ARV. So if you're an investor buying at a good discount, we'll loan you up to 75% of that ARV on a buy and hold. That means you may not have to bring any money to closing. Okay, and then once you go to refinance, they'll loan you up to 75, and there's a few out there that'll go a little higher, and then you just roll those closing costs in if you're buying less than 70, like most people do, and then you roll it into where you do 75. Where if you went straight conventional or you were able to do it, they're going to be loan to cost, meaning no matter how big a discount you buy that property, they're going to make you put a minimum 20% down plus all your repairs and closing costs. Which that makes your mortgage a lot less, so your cash flow goes up a little bit on that property. But the key, if you want to do multiple properties, is you need to hang on to your assets, because once you run out of cash, nobody else is going to loan you money, either short term or long term. So it allows you to hold on to your cash, do more properties, and make more cash flow each month and build more net worth over a period with more properties.
Okay, so if I weren't buying with hard money, tell me how it would work if I just went straight to either paying with the money out of my own pocket. Let's say I had, you know, $100,000 to buy the house and another $30,000 to rehab. How would that work versus how would it work if I just went straight to, let's say I have a friend in the mortgage business and I just want to buy a straight mortgage. I mean, I'm going to be a lot more money out of pocket and I'm going to have my money tied up a lot longer. Explain how that works.
Well, yeah, they're gonna base that purchase, what, no matter how big a discount you buy that, they're gonna base it off of loan to cost. They're gonna make you bring a minimum 20% down. They're gonna make you pay your repairs out of pocket plus your closing costs. Let's say of that $100,000, that took up $50,000 of your money. Okay? All right, and now you've got one house. If you do that the second time, and that $100,000's gone after two, you come to an asset-based lender like me, and let's say you're buying that property at 50 cents on the dollar, and it's going to take $20,000 in repairs. I could loan you 100% of that property. Then you go refinance with that conventional, because once you own it and it becomes a refinance, they base their loan off of ARV, and they can roll those closing costs. Now, if you got into a property with no money out of pocket, let's just say that, you could buy infinite amount of properties, but let's say you put 10% down instead of that 50% when you didn't use a hard money company. That would allow you to go 10 properties compared to two. How much more cash flow each month and how much more wealth you would build over the next 10 years with 10 properties as opposed to two.
Yeah, that's right. So really, using hard money is going to reduce your out-of-pocket because you can borrow based on not the purchase price. So let's say I'm going in and the purchase price, I'm buying a rental property and the purchase price is $100,000. And let's say that the ARV of the house is $150,000. Well, a traditional bank, a mortgage company, they're going to lend based on 80% of the $100,000 purchase. So you're only going to be able to borrow $80,000, but you're going to be able to loan up to 75% of the $150,000.
Of the $150,000.
Which is about $120,000. So instead of being able to borrow, so you can borrow $40,000 more, so you get the extra money to even go towards the repairs, and then the bank looks at it, instead of saying, hey, we're going to loan you 80% based on what you've got in it, they're going to say, hey, you've already got a loan, and they look at a hard money loan like any other loan, and they say, we'll do a rate and term refinance because we see the rate you've got, and you've seen, so we're just basically doing a refinance. So their rules are different for a refinance versus what a purchase is. So we're taking advantage of their rules and using hard money to do the purchase, and then we get better terms on a refinance from a bank than what we do from a purchase.
And I hear this every day, Tom. Oh, well, I don't want to pay two closing costs. Okay, listen. If you're doing that without putting money out of your pocket, and let's say you pay an extra $3,000 to $4,000 in closing costs, but you're rolling that into a 30-year amortization at 5.5% rate, what doesn't make sense about that?
Yeah, you're adding an extra $5 or $7 or maybe $10 a month to your payment. It's like that doesn't move the needle, but you can buy more properties because you have less money out of pocket. What it really does is most people don't understand is the more you're leveraging, and we don't recommend leveraging more than like 5 to 1. So you have 20% in the deal, you're leveraged the other 80%, but at most. But when you're leveraged on appreciation, if you're getting 5% appreciation, you're actually getting a 25% rate of return on the money you have in the deal. The music says I'm out of time. Johnny, as always,
I take it every day.
It's jetlending.com, 281-872-7800, 281-872-7800. Give him a call.
Thank you.
Mike's off.
All right, thanks.
Before I met you, I'll break 1,000 more, baby. Before I am through.
Hello, real estate investors. Do you need a lender that moves fast at the speed of a jet to fund your investment properties? Jet Lending will help you purchase properties quickly with as little cash out of pocket as possible. Jet Lending also sets up a repair escrow fund to help you with repair costs. Jet Lending has originated over 2,000 loans in Texas valued at over $250 million. Jet Lending will help you evaluate your deals for free and give you feedback on value, cost of repairs, and potential loan amount. Jet Lending is your fast and friendly hard money source for first-time investors and seasoned professionals. Call 281-872-7800 or email us at info@jetlending.com. Oh, and don't forget about our famous Third Wednesday Super Investor Networking Meeting. Lots of fun, lots of great real estate talk. We'll see you there.
Real estate investors, if you're not familiar with Quest IRA, let me tell you what you're missing. We've got free weekly educational classes, networking opportunities, and the ability to tap into trillions of dollars for your real estate investing deals. Come by our office or join us remotely as we simulcast all of our educational classes every Tuesday morning and evening. For more information, call us at 1-855-FUN-IRAs or visit our website at questira.com.
Time is money in a real estate deal. If your insurance company is slow or non-responsive, you could lose a deal like that. You need a quick turnaround on quotes, binders, and the agency for that is Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas. The team at Benchmark understands the investor mindset. They know what you need and when you need it. It's there for you. Call Houston's leading real estate risk management experts, Benchmark Insurance Group of Texas, 281-569-4353. That's 281-569-4353. Or online at benchmarkbroker.com.
Are you looking for an investor-friendly general contractor for your investment property? Then call Fast Track Remodeling at 832-742-9992 or reach us on the web at fasttrackremodeling.com.
Fast Track Remodeling specializes in turnkey remodeling of single-family investment properties, whether it's a flip, rehab, or a rental rehab. No more managing it yourself. No more doing the work yourself. Fast Track Remodeling really does manage it all.
So give us a call today at 832-742-9992.
Taxes. Just the sound of that word makes people cringe. At Anderson Advisors, we provide tax reduction through asset protection for real estate investors throughout the country. Our unique philosophy has CPAs, lawyers, bookkeepers, and estate planners with one common goal, helping you, the real estate investor. Check us out today at AndersonAdvisors.com. And don't forget to tell us you heard about us at Right Path Real Estate.
Selecting a foundation company and their product for repair is a lot like a game of chance. You simply don't know what you're going to get. The foundation repair industry as a whole doesn't carry a license, nor is it regulated. However, Foundation Check utilizes professional engineers to review all of our files to give you the best foundation analysis in today's market.
2 minutes.
Remember to check before every repair.
Oh, call we have, let's see,
30 seconds. Or you can reach us online at foundationcheck.com.
You found or inherited a great investment property. Problem is, you don't know how much it's worth, or more importantly, what to do to maximize your investment while mitigating risk. This is exactly why we started Next Gen Appraisals. Next Gen is a group of appraisers specializing in investment real estate. We understand that investors aren't just looking for a number of what their property is worth, but a comprehensive analysis of the market. Give NextGen a call at 713-346-9911 or check us out online at nextgenappraisals.com.
This is Business 1110.
All right, hot mics.
Hey, welcome back. Right Path Real Estate Radio, 713-785-1817. You know, there's a lot of people, or there's a lot of ways that people will make some decisions not understanding the consequence of that decision. And the result of that decision is that they are actually reducing their rate of return on their investment. And let me give you an example. If there were a way that you could make an investment and you were making 7% rate of return, but based on some decisions that seem really, really smart, but if you were a little bit more educated about how financing works and how the marketplace works, things like that, you could increase without increasing your risk, you could, and without any more money out of pocket, without anything else, you could go from 7% to 14% without changing anything else. Would you want to know about that? And the answer is obviously an emphatic yes. Well, what if it wasn't 14%, but it was 21%? Or what if it wasn't 21%, it was actually 28%? Or what if it wasn't 28%, it was actually 35%? I mean, imagine if you're buying something and you get a 7% rate of return, or you buy it slightly different based on knowledge that you don't currently have, based on information that you're not aware of, and you go from a 7% rate of return to a 35% rate of return, would you want to know about that? Well, those are the kind of things that the wealthy really understand. Wealthy really understand finances, especially if they're self-created wealth. They really understand how financing works and what an interest rate arbitrage is, what borrowing costs are versus investing costs. You know, if you're investing and getting a 35% rate of return, do you really care if your money costs you 10%? And for most people, they only know the very small slice of the financing world. And they really don't understand all the different ways that you can get creative without increasing your risk. And if you want to learn more about that, what you really need to do
one
is
come
to our next Wealth and Income workshop. We actually have one today at 12 o'clock. It's going to be at our new offices here at 13501 KD Freeway. That's 13501 KD Freeway. And all you have to do is head over to rightpathrealestate.com. That's rightpathrealestate.com and register for this free event. It'll be our last one during the week. I'll actually be doing it personally. Most of the time, I don't do the free workshop.
30 seconds.
Normally, we've got a very talented and skilled person named Ryan that does our free Wealth and Income workshop. It's our introductory workshop, but he
took
a vacation today. He's going to be out of town. So I personally, if you want to see me talking about wealth and income and how you can grow your wealth and income long-term, create a real legacy for your family.
10 seconds.
How to increase rates of return from 7 to 14 to 21 to 28 to even 35%. Come register at rightpathrealestate.com. Thanks for listening. I'll be in the studio tomorrow. Have a great day, guys.